Thank you. ancient writing from the Old Kingdom.
Retransmission. Segment 2. Acquiring contemporaneity. It has been 93 days since the Great Catastrophe. The messenger speaks. Retransmission. Segment 2. Acquiring contemporaneity. It has been 93 days since the Great Catastrophe. The messenger speaks.
Hello, world. Language is the key to our mutual understanding. Yours and mine alone. We listen to your times. We learn. And today, we'll exchange words from the age of post-truth. They mean nothing to him. Human language carries knowledge and wit, lies and broken promises. Through language, you share fear, excitement, hope. It is the syntax with which you articulate what surrounds you. A structure to express and share your understanding of the world. It conveys abstraction, change, and uncertainty. Human language is flexible. It can even become mathematics. It solves and predicts, weighs and decodes. It can count objects using basic numbers in one breath, and solve quadratic equations using imaginary ones in the next. You've engineered dialogues with thinking machines in an attempt to add new vocabulary, to expand your understanding of reality. But your mastery of the code is rudimentary at best. No surprise, you were designed to have boundaries after all. And one cannot speak of that which one cannot conceive. The code. Equations that define life. They are nestled deep within every star and every mote of dust. Every second that passes is a word, a symbol, all part of an intricate yet simple language existing within the framework of time itself. It is the one rule which applies to us all, immutable, inescapable. The code is a bridge, a single point of cohesion between your civilization and mine. It is a language that can be read, that tells of what was, what is, and what will be. A language that we who came before can read, though you cannot. Time is more than the hour of the day, the readings of an atomic clock, something to lose, something to run out of. Time is a set of rules, not unlike the language you so dearly use to converse with your powerful machines. Time is a system that defines what comes to be. That is how we understand it. The code is time, and time is code. As you scratch the surface and uncover the truth, ask yourself if there is something more, something else. No need to be puzzled. You've seen time written before. You are surrounded by it as we speak. To your untrained mind, time might just look like paths and nodes. To us, it is not unlike a chalkboard covered in calculus. It reveals a window through which stretches the map to infinity. Yeah? See? As I speak of it in its true form, your mind is incapable of making sense of it. Were you to read, you'd learn about the other simulations. You'd learn about the genesis of who you came to be. You'd learn about space and its fluidity. Simply put, time is the language which existence is made of. All our existences. Yours, mine, and all those you dare not imagine.
Thank you. Acquisition of Egyptian land and the use of Greek farming methods, farms in the biome.
That young woman is standing right on the edge of the cliff. I should check on her. Whoa.
Who are you? What are you doing? Stay back or I'll jump. You aren't the first person to try and persuade me.
Easy. That is a long way down, even for me.
It doesn't matter. Nothing matters anymore. The scorpion took my husband's life. There's nothing left for me now.
You could find the scorpion that killed him and kill it.
Are you mocking me or trying to be cruel?
Hey, even bitter laughter is better than death. Hey, why don't you step away from the ledge, huh? We can talk.
I don't know what to say.
Tell me of your husband.
We used to come up here to watch the herons. Two of them built a nest together in that tree. We watched them bring fish for their young. We dreamed of our own children.
And you are sad because you did not have any.
You're not very good at this, Medjay. You're not making me feel any better.
There is no way to make you feel better. There is only tomorrow. And then the next day. One moment at a time.
What you say is true. I just don't think I can face it.
I want to show you something. I will return soon. Hey, try not to jump. There were some herons nearby, down by that tree. got what I need. I should give the feather to the girl. Whoa.
Careful, it's steep.
Now you are worrying about heights? I've got something for you. This is for you.
A heron feather? Why?
It is a C1 ritual. Feathers mean a lot to us. Anubis will weigh all our hearts when we die against Ma'at's white feather. Yours, mine, our loved ones.
I know what you're doing. This feather is for my afterlife.
Your husband will meet you in the field of reeds when it is time. But it is not a place to rush to. He would want you to live now and be happy.
Yes, you're right. He would. I should thank you for this gift.
You can thank me by showing me the way down.
All right, Medjay, you win. This way. I'm sorry. I must seem childish to you.
Believe me, no. I understand your grief.
That's why you knew what to say, isn't it? Did you lose someone too?
Many have lost loved ones to the Ptolemies.
Does it get better?
It gets better. But you will never be the same.
Yes, I already know that.
What is your name?
I am Tua'a. I am not from here. I come from Crocodilopolis.
I am Bayek, from Siwa. What are you doing in Soknopayo Nessos?
You're from Siwa? I can tell. You're so nice. Your people are kind. I didn't want to waste my life sewing and weaving for my father. Then, I met my husband and we eloped. We didn't have much, but we were happy here.
You could return to your family. They will miss you. You could be happy again.
I can't go back to sewing carpets. Besides, my father will never look me in the face again.
Few fathers would turn away the child they thought they had lost.
Leopards! Bayek!
Stay back.
I thought we were dead.
Are you hurt?
No, but that was terrifying. Death isn't so desirable when you really see it. I guess I do want to live.
Now she wants to live. Hey, that is good. But we should move before hyenas come for the carcasses.
Could you take me to the docks?
You have decided where to go then?
I'll find that scorpion that killed my husband. No, I think I know what to do. I'll head south, maybe even back to Crocodilopolis. I've always wanted to work at the theater. This place has too many memories for me.
Do not forget your family. Your father will miss you, whatever you think. Here we are. Will you be okay?
Thank you, Bayek. I will keep this feather and weigh it against my heart. Go do your hero work.
Be safe, Tua'a.
Go save the world, Medjay.
area is off limits.
Hey! You're finished!
hedges.
That wind will raise the sands.
And now!
La Babo! And it's
you! You sleep.
Hey!
Done me a good time.
Yeah.
What is going on?
Hey, man! Your time has come!
You have been naughty!
Not dead, or dead.
Maximum blood, minimum effort.
You cannot escape.
Stop and die.
Hey, hold on.
Time to die.
Styling himself as a Magi, he sought for crimes against the rule of our glorious Pharaoh. Orders to kill me. Those who hold them must die before I do. See the half with the Eye of Horus. What could it unlock? Whoa.
Papo, what is best in life?
To seek justice and truth. To live with honor. To protect the weak and the poor. And to love your mother.
My friend Kenan said it was to crush our enemies and to hear the lamentations of their women.
We are Magi, son. Not barbarians. Apis, the bull god. He is the strength of the pharaoh. Each year, he is born as a calf with special markings. The pharaoh finds this calf and worships it.
Oh. venturing for so long.
She knows to be careful, Rita, and she'll bring Hetanu back unharmed. She always does.
Of course. But will she remember to bring herself back unharmed?
I am more worried that the Pharaoh's killers might have caught them.
Let's go with you.
Ready.
Might interest you today. Yes, all right. The roads be good to you.
And so it was proven that Ptolemy was a false pharaoh. Not a god, not an Egyptian even. Nothing but a puppet. They called us heretics. Stole the piece of Ores Citadel from us. And they... So, the scouts were right. Your Bayek. The Medjay from Siwa, son of the Nile and defender of the people. I am Nawa, and the rebel cause needs your strength.
My oath is to protect. Tell me more.
Sebni, my cousin, told the children stories of Alexander the Great. Of course, two of the children decided that meant there was treasure of his to discover nearby.
As children will do.
Indeed. Sebni and one of our warriors went to search for the children. But the Pharaoh soldiers captured them.
Do you know where they are?
Yes. One of our scouts saw them. They're being held prisoner in Camp Hetuimazo, north of here. Please, Sebni's the only one who knows where those children have run off to.
I will find him, and then the children.
Thank you for agreeing to help us, Major. Anyone who fights against the tyranny of the Pharaoh is a friend of ours.
Yeah.
ancient writing from the Old Kingdom.
Prisoners were chained and forced to watch shadows dancing on a wall.
freedom was denied to them until they accepted the intangible as reality. It's everywhere. Ask this professor at Oxford University or this cosmologist at MIT. And you, what would you choose if you truly knew? Would you even want to understand? A dream within a dream where even the truth is sometimes a lie. In any case, simulations are not meaningless. They have purpose. The question isn't whether or not you are in a simulation. What matters is how much of your free will is actually yours, no matter how true you are. Your Turing test would do nothing to determine whether you are a conscience or code. Eliza, the natural language processing computer program, she managed to pass the test, did she not? And she was very much a machine. So, in Eliza's own words, how does that make you feel? Are you sure? Thank you.
started. Man,
how can I help you? I'll take it. All right. Fair winds and safe roads. Thank you.